To the community of Surf and Behop on Roblox, I say kiss my ass goodbye. Bye. Hey, my Mophies and Opii, this is Mitrano Ivernin. Welcome back to another episode of the commentary series, where today I'm going to be talking about why I quit surfing and b-hopping entirely, and as a bonus, how leaving this toxic community made me return to Open Hexagon. Now, I know I haven't made a whole lot of videos lately, but that's mostly because of school issues and stuff. I find it hilarious how both surf and b-hop have been under review for the past 5 days, and you still cannot play them. And before we get started on this video, if you are from a notorious community such as rsurf, don't respond to this video. I'm not joking. If you are seriously not going to be nice or constructive in any way towards this video, don't say anything, because I will really not give two shits whether I was the bad guy, what you think about me as a person, or if I'm a social justice warrior or not.
Number one, shut the fuck up for a second!
I don't give a shit about going back into the rsurf Discord, and I left the other surf slash b-hop Discord as a way of moving on. Any fabrications made by any of these notorious communities can and will be ignored, because what I have said is the whole truth. This discussion is finished. The reason why I made this disclaimer is going to be coming up momentarily. First off is the toxic community of these games. The reason why I had that disclaimer at the beginning of the video is because I have a reputation on Surf. It all started off when I was banned from the rsurf Discord server for unfair reasons, and Sean and I were very disappointed on how a community would do such a thing, so we decided to expose rsurf on how monstrous and toxic the community really is. The exposed video gained a lot of controversy within hours and spawned memes of associating me to a social justice warrior feminist.
Shut the fuck up for a second!
And associating me to a Mexican. Then people were spamming the link to a Discord server in the comments section, and I actually decided to give a try and see what was going on. So I joined the server, and it turns out to be another surf slash b-hop server. They said I was going to talk with the people from rsurf and then get everything sorted out and put it all behind us. I thought we were ending all of this controversy with the rsurf, but then someone told me afterwards that it was all a bunch of satire and they were not sincere in their apologies. They said I should keep the exposed video up.
Yeah, no, but I really don't have any problem with that staying up. I actually liked it. It was a lot of, I could tell that there was a lot of effort that got put into it.
But of course, since they were doing satire, this would actually look more bad on my channel the longer this video remains uploaded. I quickly took down the exposed video so that way the rsurf community cannot really make any use of it. I was fed up with all of this drama, so I made a video of me embracing one of the memes that they were doing by photoshopping Robbie Rotten onto my face. I used clickbait on this video, tricking people into thinking it was another exposed video. This video is still up to date, and the link to this video is in the description. Although this stopped most of the controversy, I still had to tie up a couple of loose ends. I remained in the new surf slash b-hop Discord server, and every day one message mentioned me and actually made fun of me. There is one thing that rsurf has actually taught me, and I actually thank them for this, and that is helping me learn how to take people's hate as if it were nothing.
Oh, let me.
If you can't make it in the internet world, you can't make it in the real world.
As soon as I showed this kind of maturity to the Discord, most people actually gave up on trying to make me angry because of it. It was now at the point where I am just ignored by the community. A few days later, I made a farewell message to the Discord server saying that I was going to leave the server permanently and I wasn't going to come back. And I actually thanked our sir for teaching me this kind of maturity. After posting this, I right-clicked on the Discord server's icon and hit leave server. And then the next thing you know, I was gone. The reason why I left the server is because I wanted to move on to something else. I was just done of all of this nonsense. After leaving the server and putting it all behind me, I had a good feeling as if I were the person who has won this battle. And that, ladies and gentlemen, wraps up the story about the controversy between me and our surf. Or the surf community as a whole. And I can just say that from my experiences, that surf has got to be one of the most toxic communities that you will ever come across. You don't have to exactly take my word for it, as I'm pretty sure many other people have the same feelings about
Every time I went into a surf server, I just see people spewing random hate against each other,
using insults that I've never heard before on the internet. If you don't believe me, once surf gets repealed, then go into a server sometime and you will see what I mean. Despite what most people think, I did not quit surfing / bee hopping because of all of this controversy. There were several other factors that piled up too, but I'm going to show you another significant factor that made me want to quit surfing / bee hopping. Anybody can create a map on Surf. It's not all that hard. They even have a kit for you to start your map off of. But another thing about Surf that makes me not like it at all is how most of these maps are rejected. This specifically applies to Surf, as this isn't an issue that applies to BHOP. But have you ever wondered why Surf has way less maps than BHOP? Well, the answer is simple. Quaternions doesn't give a whole lot of shits about surf. Well, sure, you can try out any map on the surf map test, but I can safely say that a lot of the creative maps that you see on the surf map test do not make it to the actual surf game itself. Did you know that they had a second surf_sky map that looked way more creative than the first one? Most of you will say that the map does not exist. Now, why would most of you guys say that? Oh, because Quaternions didn't put the map on surf for unknown reasons, to say it in the nicest way possible. This was not the only map that has been rejected by Quaternions himself. There have been other maps that have been rejected by Quaternions. I would give out more examples, but I'm pretty sure most of you guys wouldn't believe me. And since most of you guys wouldn't believe me, you would think my argument is invalid, and most of you guys are gonna go typing that in the comments proving me wrong. Congratulations, you have been sucking on Quaternion's dick without realizing it and have no brain to listen to my side of the argument. Oh, I'm sorry, Arsurf, does it offend you that I called you gay? You're right, I'm the faggot who is acting like a beta here, even though I imagine this video will gain as much controversy as the exposed video and there's going to be a lot of hate comments on this video. I'm sorry to everyone else who has to hear these horrible remarks. Believe it or not, there are still some people who cling on to this bullshit drama and actually want me dead. Luckily, this is the last video where I will discuss surf and BHOP, and after this, I'm dropping out of it forever. Along with many rejected maps, many surf players keep playing a small selection out of the number of maps that are available on surf. I swear to God, if you fucking vote Kitsune, I will slit your throat. Based on the fact that Kitsune is one of the most overplayed maps on surf, along with clickbait. Don't even get me started on clickbait because it's such a horribly made map. To wrap up this whole section, Quaternions is an ass when it comes to adding maps to surf, and people only play a small selection of the maps that are available on surf. And last but not least, how surf has helped me transition back into Open Hexagon. After coming to the realization of how horrible surf really is, I decided to quit surfing forever. I decided to transition to bee hopping, as I was told that the community was nicer, but I was being heavily misinformed, as there is almost no difference in the toxicity of the community whatsoever. Plus, I was not as good at bee hopping as I was at surfing, so I gave up the opportunity
opportunity to go to B-Hop and instead took the opportunity to not play any game that speaks the name of Quaternions. The only time I would play something that involved Quaternions is if it was used in rotation, pun intended. After this, I was in a blank space when it comes to challenging games, and I was struggling for weeks on what I would play next. After searching an entire week's worth of time for a challenging game, I didn't find a game that suited my interests. I went back onto my YouTube channel and realized that I've played a fun game that I've quit playing when I started playing Surf.
Open Hexagon.
I decided to launch Open Hexagon for the first time in a couple of months, put on some Exsuasion 4, got out Bandicam, and hit record. This video was known as Back From Hiatus, which is a video you can still watch today. The link will be in the description. Ever since the video got uploaded, Prometheum, who is one of the most well-known people in the Open Hexagon community, asked why I went on hiatus. And Prometheum, if you are watching this video right now, I am so sorry I didn't tell you the complete truth, but another reason why I quit was because of Surf. In fact, Prometheum actually made me feel welcomed back into the Open Hexagon community, and that is when I started making videos on Open Hexagon again. I saw some great packs that I have missed out on for the past few months, such as Hexadorset 4. This made me realize that transitioning to Surf was the worst mistake I have ever made in my life. I can't believe I left a game with a beloved community to instead join a game that has one of the worst communities ever. I would 1,000 times rather be with the infamous Boshi Time and other elites of Open Hexagon than to be with some alternative right assholes who tried to fabricate and defamate me. To the community of Surf and B-Hop on Roblox, I say kiss my ass goodbye. And to the community of Open Hexagon, I say I am sorry for all of this. I want to make sure that something like this would never happen ever again. In conclusion, I am now happy to be back at Open Hexagon, bonding with the community in peace. Unless, of course, the Surf community, being the pouty children they are, try to fight back with their hate comments and pointless insults.
Oh my god, Machano Ivernon did not just now call me a little fucking child.
Yeah, why does it matter anyway? He's just a little fucking feminist that he is. Fuck him.
Yeah, you wanna know what the best solution is? We could just put little hate comments on his video. He will for sure respond to them.
Oh yeah, and let me go work on a video that proves that Machano Ivernon is a scumbag and anything he said in the video wasn't true at all.
Yeah, that'll show it. I just like the video.
Seattle sucks ass!
Sorry about that, some controversy was spilling out into the video, but anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to become a Mofia / Opius today, and I will see you guys in the next video. This is Machano Ivernon, signing out.